In our main event, Bellator 224, taking place Friday from Thackerville, Oklahoma, you have Julia Budd defending her featherweight belt against Olga Rubin. Matt, Julia Budd's been totally dominant since she's entered the game. Can you tell us a little bit about her?
I mean, Julia Budd, she really is one of the pioneers of the women's MMA. Her only two losses are to Ronda Rousey and Amanda Nunes, who are considered two of, if not the best, women's fighters of all time. And then ever since that, she's been completely undefeated. Like Craig said, ever since she's been in Bellator, just pretty much ran over most people who she's fighting. And honestly, it's going to be hard to even find her an equal in this Bellator division. So I understand what they're doing. She has to fight someone eventually, but I feel like this should be a pretty easy win for her.
Fairly fair matchup, actually, compared to what we've seen in the past. I mean, of course, we have Arlene Blanco on the undercard of this, and she has maybe a salty record, but a couple of splits, one split, one majority decision fight there. But for Olga Rubin, 6-0, big bad. She's got 3 wins by knockout, TKO, 3 by decision. Should be a good fight on paper. I mean, you look at Olga Rubin, who started fighting as a pro in 2016, wins in her last two over Cindy Dandwa, UFC vet, and Ione Razafierzin. And I mean, that was a good win there, another Cindy decision. Dandwa. She's somebody that splits time between her native Israel and England. Her head coach is actually Brad Pickett. She trains there with him. Like I said, splits camps between the two. She had for this one, and I had a chance to talk to her. Audio didn't quite work out in that one, but as far as the odds are concerned in this fight, they do to me make sense. I mean, Julia Budd looking at like a minus 350 at this point. You've got Olga Rubin at about a plus 300. Matt, who are you going to pick in this one?
I'm taking Julia Budd without a doubt. I mean, her wrestling really should be the X factor in this fight, and I feel like she should be able to either grind out a decision win, a one-sided one, or get TKO at some point.
Yeah, and I'm going to be taking Budd in this one, but really looking forward to a good night of fights. Make sure you check out all the other previews, and we'll be back with more previews for UFC Sacramento coming up on YouTube, iTunes, Stitcher, wherever you get your podcasts, at Craig.